to give you, the coach, some information about sports nutrition. So the first thing that you did on that tennis court out there is sweat. So one of the topics in my presentation today would be about rehydration. So I'm going to talk to you about, very quickly, 40 minutes is not enough. Nutrition lectures can last as long as 3 hours. But I'm going to touch base on just some small points that you as a coach can subscribe or prescribe to your players. Number one is how to eat, when to eat, what to eat, hydration strategies, supplements, competition diets, training diets. Now, in a tennis player, when they come to me, these are the basic questions that I would be asking them. As a coach, these are some of the basic things that you could be asking them. I work as the introducer, presenter introduced me. I work with Olympic medalist Sushil Kumar. This is one thing that I would like to share with you is, around a year ago, I worked with a lady, her name is Dinaz. She went on to break the Guinness World Record of non-stop aerobics. That is 26 hours of non-stop aerobics. Now, as a coach, I want to ask you this one question. How long do you think the human body can push itself? Depends on the athlete. Depends on the athlete better. This lady did 26 hours. You know what was the biggest concern for me? How to fuel the athlete. And as a coach, you may face the problem, which is cramping. How do tennis players avoid cramping? Imagine a tennis. What is the normal longest duration of a tennis game? About 5 hours? 11 hours was the world record, right? Okay, so imagine a player playing for 11 hours, but a standard game for which you as a coach are training your individual is around 2 to 3 hours. So you need to develop nutrition for your player, one, for training. Second, you need to develop nutrition for competition. I'll talk to you briefly how to do it. The Olympic Center of Excellence says that you need to carefully, for muscle enhancement, in whatever game you're playing, training, nutrition, rest and recovery. Alright? 33% focus on all. The problem in our country, the problem in India is, as a coach, I don't know if you'll agree or disagree with me, is that our players have a diverse culture. So if you're coming in from North India, it's a paratha for breakfast. And if you're coming in from Tamil Nadu, it's an idli sambar for breakfast. However, when a Chennai player goes to Delhi to play, or when a Delhi player comes to Chennai to play, sir, I'm not getting my proper breakfast, that's why I lost my game. Yeah? Sharmada Balu, when she was talking to me last time when I was doing her counselling, she said, but Ryan, I went to Spain and I couldn't get my normal stuff over there. The first tip. So what I do is, I work with an athlete and say, please cut your taste buds. Okay? And think about performance nutrition. And in performance nutrition, we have proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, fats, nutritional supplements. I'll talk about supplements also, which are legal, which are illegal. I hope I can squeeze that in 40 minutes. But if somebody wants to stand on top of the podium, it's not about idli sambar and it's not about paratha. It's about how you can train that athlete's taste bud to eat. And it's a very important aspect for you as a coach to encourage your players to have a multicultural palate. Very, very important. A lot of coaches come to me and say, Ryan, please give the diet plan. And suddenly in my diet plan, I've given an intercontinental menu. The parent comes back to me and complains, sir, you have given grilled chicken with baked potatoes. My child is from Chennai. How can you give such a food? We don't prepare this at home. Now, you have to have a vision. What is the vision? You need to train the palate of the child to accept cultural foods. And, people come to me straight and say, please give me performance nutrition. It's not about performance nutrition, not about supplements. It's about first learning how to eat for your game. Two things. They focus on foundation nutrition. They focus on foundation nutrition and performance nutrition.